Hey guys! Okay, so we're gonna do 20 minutes of ab work today. I don't have any music today because my music keeps cutting in and out for some reason. So we're just gonna enjoy the sounds of nature in the sunroom. Let's go ahead and get started. So just a 20 minute quick ab burnout today. Let's start seated on the mat. Go ahead and bring your feet together, knees together, knees are bent, feet are gonna stay on the floor. We're gonna reach those arms straight out in front of you, palms facing each other, shoulders out of ears. Sit super tall, take a nice big inhale. And then as you exhale, go ahead and just start to tuck your tailbone and start rolling your spine. One vertebra at a time into the mat. So going nice and slow, especially at that little sticky spot in your back here. We're gonna let the head come all the way down and stretch the arms all the way back. And then as you inhale, float your arms up to the ceiling. And as you exhale, give me a little tuck of your chin towards your chest. Keep your chest open wide as you start to curl back up, one bone at a time. Think about stacking those vertebrae. Get nice and tall at the top, lengthen your spine, and then go ahead and go again. Tuck your pelvis under, so get that tailbone to curl. Get your belly button to hollow in away from your waistband. And then bone by bone, you're just melting into that mat. All the way down. Make sure your ribs do not pop open too much as you reach your arms back. And then float your arms up to the ceiling. And exhale, scoop your belly. Keep a little apple-sized space between your chin and chest. You're not just using your neck here. And then stack your spine. Sit up nice and tall. Melt your shoulders out of your ears. Reach the crown of your head to the ceiling. Let's go for two more. Tuck that pelvis. Use your legs here, so don't be afraid to press into your heels a little bit and feel like you're really anchored. You're squeezing your inner thighs and your glutes. Again, arms reach back. The ribs stay knit together. You're not letting them flare. And then inhale, float them up. And exhale, scoop your belly, curl back up. Shoulders stay down, away from your neck. Lengthen at the top, sit tall, big breath in. Last time, exhale, we're gonna tuck and roll all the way down for your final time here. Rolling back vertebra by vertebra. Reach through the arms, keep those ribs pulled together and down into you. Float them up, inhale. And then exhale, let's go ahead and come up like halfway. So you're gonna come up a little bit past those shoulder blades, but still behind your sit bones. And then from there, lift your right arm. Exhale, bring it back down, and then inhale, lift your left arm, and exhale, bring it back down. So your goal is to keep your pelvis and your spine perfectly stable here. You're not letting your chest bounce up and down. You're not letting your hips rock. Shoulders stay melted down that back. So think about anchoring your shoulder blades into your back pockets. As you exhale and pull the arm down, your belly button pulls back even deeper. Okay, we're gonna do one more each side, right arm up. Exhale, scoop that belly, bring it down. Last time, left arm up. Exhale, scoop that belly, bring it back down and hold it here. And then you're gonna inhale, open up your arms. Exhale, hug your tree. Inhale, open, and exhale, hug. So again, your body is not rocking or bouncing forward and back. As you exhale to close your arms, you're pulling your belly button in a little bit deeper, trying to get that core to shake a little bit here. Let's go for three. Last two, make sure your collarbones stay wide. Okay, last one, we're gonna hug it in and hold, shoulders out of ears. Now pulse your chest, 1 inch up and 1 inch down. As you do your pulse, make sure that you're not just bouncing, you're not using momentum. You're truly trying to get that belly button to scoop in a little bit deeper, and that is what lifts you up. Let's go for five. Last four, relax those shoulders again for three. Awesome job, you guys, for two. Okay, last one, we're gonna hold it right here, take a big breath in, and then as you exhale, go ahead and melt the rest of the way down your back. One bone at a time into that mat, and then let's float those arms all the way back and stretch. Let's extend the legs. You can take a moment just to arch your back a little bit, get that belly to open up and stretch, and then rein it right back in. So pull the back of your ribs into the mat. Then let's keep those legs zipped together. Press your heels into the floor so you feel your booty turn on. And then as you inhale, we're gonna float those arms back up to the ceiling, similar to before, but now the legs are straight. As you exhale, little tuck of your chin, scoop your belly, and start to roll up. This is called the roll up. Keep your arms active. active, that means they do not drop to the ground, they stay right by your ears. And then from here, reach forward, but at the same time, pull your belly back and feel like your lower back is stretching towards that wall behind you. Shoulder blades are in your back pockets still. Make sure you're not hiking those shoulders. From here, we're gonna sit up nice and tall. Keep your shoulders unshrugged, but push your arms up like you're reaching towards the ceiling. And then keep your biceps framing your ears as you tuck your tailbone. Roll through your spine. Again, one vertebra at a time. You're melting your way all the way down into that mat. Let's do that again, the roll up. Inhale, float your arms up. Exhale, little tuck of that chin. Make sure your legs do not pop up. You keep squeezing your booty, keep them anchored. And then curl up and reach forward. But at the same time, pull your belly button back. It's like you've got a band around your belly. It's pulling you back towards that wall behind you. Scoop, feel that great big stretch. And then inhale, sit up tall. Shoulders stay anchored, but you're pushing something off of you with those hands. Keep the arms active as you roll through your spine. Tuck your hips. And again, try to get that little massage of your spine, smoothing over any sticky spots in your back as you make your way down to the mat. Let's just go one more time. Inhale, float your arms up. Exhale, scoop your belly, rolling up. Find that great big stretch. So reach forward, but at the same time, pull your belly back. Pull your lower back into that wall behind you. Shoulders out of ears. Sit up super tall, keep the arms engaged, and roll yourself all the way back down, bone by bone, into your mat. Very good. Okay, so from here, pull up the pants. Let's go ahead and bring those legs into tabletop. So you're gonna bring your knees bent right above your hips, tailbone heavy on the ground, arms reach up to the ceiling. Take a nice big inhale. As you exhale, you're just gonna lift your chest and press your arms down by your sides. Your arms are active though. They're plugged into your back. Your collarbones are wide. You're extending, reaching, stretching out through those fingertips. And then on the way back down, I want you to work that belly, resist as you melt your shoulder blades and float the arms to the sky. Let's go again. Exhale, curl up. Make sure your collarbones stay wide. You're not letting your chest cave in. Fire up your back, fire up your lats. And then lower back down with control. Ah, nice and active, both directions. Let's go for four. Exhale, curling up. That tailbone stays heavy. You are not rocking your knees towards your chest. Ooh, last three here. Exhale, curl. Inhale, slowly lower down just for two more. Think about that belly button like it's getting drilled into the mat. Okay, last one, we're gonna curl up and we're gonna hold it up at the top so you'll stay lifted. Again, melt your shoulders out of your ears. Extend your left leg and at the same time, pull your right leg closer towards your chest. Use your belly to do that work. And then from your belly, you're gonna switch. Push and pull those legs in opposition. And exhale, switch. And switch. If you need that extra neck support, you can always interlace your fingers and place your hands at the base of your skull. Think about using your hands there to lengthen your neck. Elbows stretch wide so that your back muscles continue to fire up. Keep scooping that navel deeper into that spine as you switch those legs. Make sure that your knees are tracking with your hip bones. You're not letting those knees splay open. Let's go for four. Really active, you guys, here. From that belly for three. Pulling it in. Just for two. Okay, on the last one, once you're even, you're gonna go ahead and bend both knees, catch your ankles, unshrug your shoulders. Let's still keep that tailbone nice and grounded. So make sure you haven't lifted your butt into the air. Settle it down and try to lift your chest higher. Stretch your mid back up and over those ribs. Okay, double leg stretch. Inhale, reach those legs out in front of you. Reach your arms overhead. Make sure your chest does not drop. And then as you exhale, circle the arms and go ahead and hug those knees. Right back in towards your chest. Inhale, stretch, reach those arms and legs to opposite sides of the room. And then exhale, try to pull everything right back into that tiny little package here. So you get really compact. And then inhale, you stretch and you take up as much space as possible. Exhale, get really compact, pull it in, keep that tailbone heavy. And inhale, stretch, take up space. Let's do just one more here. Make sure your chest does not drop at all. Keep it lifted. Inhale, reach. And then exhale, pull it all the way back in. Let's go single straight leg stretch. Right leg straight up to the ceiling. You're gonna reach and grab as close to that ankle as possible. Unshrug your shoulders and then extend your left leg out so it's hovering over that mat. Shoulders are out of your ears. You are using your arms quite a bit, pulling your chest up higher to get out of your neck here. We're gonna pull, pull, and switch. Pull, pull, and switch. Try to keep your hands lifted and reaching up, and then you're just catching that leg as it makes its way towards your hands. Pull, pull, and switch. Pull, pull, and switch. Again, pelvis anchor. Do not let your hips rock and roll. Whew. Melt that navel even deeper into that spine. And then check in that your chest is still open, your shoulders are out of your ears. Let's go ahead and do one more each side. Right leg and left leg. And then we're gonna go both legs to the ceiling. Go ahead and take those hands and release your fingers right at the base of your skull without letting your back arch. Inhale, lower those straight legs. They don't have to go super low. Instead, think of reaching out through your toes, stretching the abdominal wall. And then as you exhale, sink your belly button to get those legs to lift right back up. Inhale, those straight legs lower. And then exhale, you sink that belly button to lift those legs. So it's truly coming from the belly. You're relaxing your quads. You're relaxing your hip flexors. Sinking that belly button down to lift your legs up. Let's go for two. Shoulder blades stay off of that mat. Exhale, lift. Okay, last one here. Inhale, lower, stretch that abdominal wall. Keep your lower back anchored. Exhale, bring it up. And then go ahead and go back into that position. Right knee bent, left leg reaching out. We're gonna twist towards that right knee and then switch and switch into crisscross. This is your last in your series of five. Elbows wide. Pelvis again is not rocking. You're twisting that upper torso for four. Last three, keep scooping that navel deeper for two. Ooh, belly's burning. Last one. Let's go ahead and release. Hug those knees in. Rest your head all the way down. Really good job, you guys. Whew, nice. Okay, so from here, we're gonna keep the head down for a little bit and just give your neck a little bit of a break. We're gonna concentrate on those lower abdominals, our favorite. So let's bring those legs all the way together. Come up onto your tippy toes. Let your arms press into that mat by your sides. Let the shoulder heads themselves press into the mat and try not to let them pop up. Okay, your ribs are anchored, so even the back of your ribs, anchor them into the mat, pull that belly button down, lower back stays imprinted into the mat here. Let's go ahead and inhale. As you exhale from your low belly, you're just gonna lift that whole shape of your legs up into tabletop, and then keep the knees bent, just hinge at your hips. Inhale, you're tapping your toes back down to the mat. Exhale from your low abs, you lift that shape up, and then inhale, without letting your back pop up off the mat, you're tapping your toes down. So if that means you don't touch the ground again, that's okay. More important that you keep that lower back attached to your mat and you're not letting it arch up. That way you have to use your core, right? You're using that powerhouse to stabilize your spine. Keep the arms active. Again, press the back of those shoulder heads down. Do not let them pop up. Close the front of your ribs and try to press the back of your ribs into the mat as well. Let's go for four. Use that exhale, sink that navel to lift. For three more, exhale, scoop it right back up. We got it, you guys, just for two. Lifting those legs from that belly. Okay, last one here. You're gonna go ahead and lift your legs back up. Hold it, let's still keep the chest down. Just straighten those legs. Go back into that straight double leg lower here. You're gonna lower those legs. Again, it's not about how low they go. It's about being able to keep your lower back on the mat and feeling the stretch in your abdominal wall. So think of reaching your toes away from your belly. And then exhale, sink your navel to lift your legs back up. Try to turn off your quads, turn off your hip flexors. Inhale, reach out through your toes. You might notice when your head is down, it's a little bit harder to keep your lower back on the mat. You might not go very low. That's okay. Let's go just for three. Again, try to keep the front of the ribs closed. Don't let them pop. Exhale, scoop that belly, lift it back up. Just for two, the tailbone stays anchored. That pelvis is also stable. Okay, one more time. Lower those legs. Woo! And then exhale, lift up using that powerhouse. Really good job here, you guys. Stack your hands one on top of the other. Let's lift that chest, reach for your toes, and then inhale, lower back down. Exhale, lift, reach. Inhale, lower back down. Make sure you're not hunching your shoulders forward. Keep your collarbones wide. Keep your shoulders pulled back and out of your ears. Let's go five more. Exhale, scoop, lift it up. Inhale, lower down for four. Use that exhale breath to get deeper into the belly. Just for two more. Exhale, lift, reach for your toes. Okay, last one. We're gonna hold it up at the top. Stay lifted from here. Open your legs out to a V. Reach your hands right through your thighs and just start giving me those little pulses. So think about lifting your heart up and over your ribs. Sink your belly button even deeper into your spine to pulse up for eight, seven. Do not just bob your head. Make sure you're really using your belly here. For four, three, two, and one. Go ahead and hug those knees in. Rock it from side to side. Massage out that back. Okay, we're gonna make our way onto our tummy, so we'll roll like a ball. So you're gonna go heels together, toes apart, grab around the front of your ankles, and just for the first couple, you can do a little bit with momentum, just to get that spine to loosen up and round, massaging again any of those sticky spots out of your back. And then once you've gotten going, let's start to tighten it up. So think about keeping your heels close to your booty the whole time. Think about keeping your head as tucked between your knees as possible the whole time. For four, we're gonna end up on our bellies. So we'll cross the ankles, put your hands on the mat, hop out into a plank in two. Okay, last one, come up, cross your ankles, plant your palms, come into a plank for a second. And then from here, all we're gonna do is lower all the way down onto your tummy. Okay, so your core is not just the front, your abdominal wall, right? We wanna work the backside. Your core is that whole 360 degrees of muscle there. So back body is really important. We're gonna keep those legs nice and straight, as close together as possible. If you can zip your inner thighs, great. You don't have to though. You can have a little space if that's better on your lower back. We're gonna stack the palms, one on top of the other, and rest your forehead down on your hands. I want you to glue your forehead to your hands and vice versa, so they're always gonna stay connected. Okay, keep a little bit of a tuck of your tailbone, so see how my lower back lengthens as I reach my tailbone towards my heels, and then you're trying to pull your belly button away from the mat so that your abs are still engaged. As you inhale, you're just gonna lift the upper body, so the arms come with you as you lift your chest, elbows wide, so that you fire up your back, and then exhale, lower it back down. Inhale, lift that upper body, elbows wide, try to keep that belly button pulled up off of that mat, and exhale, lower. Let's just go for three, lift, and lower. You'll feel that zing right underneath your shoulder blades for two. Okay, on this last one, we're gonna hold it up, so we'll stay lifted, open your arms out to a T, and then from here, try to lift your chest a little higher as you reach your arms back towards your hips. Your palms are gonna end up facing the ceiling. And then you're gonna bend your elbows, bring your hands right back down underneath your forehead as you lower your chest down. So again, from those muscles in your mid-back, we're strengthening your back, working the backside of your core here. Inhale, lift. Stay lifted as you open your arms to a T. Lift higher as you squeeze your shoulder blades, reach your arms by your sides, flipping your palms to face the ceiling along the way. And then go ahead and exhale. Bend your elbows, release your palms under your forehead as you release your chest all the way down. Let's go again. Keep that little space under your belly button. Pull your abs in. Keep your tailbone reaching towards your heels. Inhale, lift. Stay lifted as you open the arms. Maybe you can lift higher as you reach your arms back. Imagine someone's pulling you back by those fingertips. And then go ahead, bend those elbows. Release it all the way back down. Let's go just two more times here. Inhale, lift. Open to a T. Maybe you can lift your chest higher as you reach back. Imagine again, someone's pulling you back. The back of your neck is long, you guys. Look at the floor. Exhale, bend your elbows. Relax it down. Okay, last one. Inhale, lift, belly button away from the mat. Open to your T.
Reach it back, palms face the ceiling, hold it here, lift your chest higher. Now start pumping those arms towards the ceiling, squeeze those triceps. Keep pulling your belly button away from the ground, squeeze your booty, keep those feet heavy for five. Big inhale, big exhale. For four, this is your reverse 100. Last three, inhale, try to get that belly button off the mat as you exhale. Two more breaths, inhale. Exhale, pull that belly button in. Last one, inhale, open your chest, lift it higher. And exhale, two, three, four, five. Relax all the way down, and then you're gonna press back. Take a little child's pose, stretch out your back here. Great job, you guys. Okay, we're gonna finish with a little bit of side body work. So you're gonna sit down, right hand on the floor, left foot in front of the right, and then left arm reaching out to the side. So we're gonna come up and over into a big rainbow. Inhale. Exhale, rainbow, up and over. This is called the side bend. Lift that waist up towards the ceiling. Try to really lift that left hip up. Push the ground away with that right hand. And then on the way down, you just reach that arm back out to the left. Tap your hips down, and then exhale, come right back up. Reach, try to get that shoulder directly on top of that right wrist. And then inhale, lower it down. And exhale, right back up. Stretch, make that big rainbow shape in your spine. Get that lateral flexion. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift. Okay, just two more here, you guys. You got it. Chin off that chest, gaze straight ahead. Exhale, lift. Good, last time. It should feel nice, like a great big stretch. Reach it over. Okay, you're gonna bring your hips down just a little bit so you're in a side plank. Look up at your left hand, thread the needle. Reach it underneath your right armpit. Twist your chest towards the ground, but keep pulling your left hip back so it doesn't go with you. Open it back up to the ceiling. Exhale, twist. Keep those hips nice and stable. Really bring out your waist and open. Last time here, exhale, twist. Reach it through, push the ground away. And then open it up. Bring your hips down, bring your heels closer to your bottom, and then stretch. That right arm comes up and over. Whew. We didn't do any teasers today, but we're gonna do one just to transition to the other side. So hands behind you, legs come up in that little supported teaser, bend your knees to the other side. And then let's do those side bends on this side. So again, you're gonna stack that left wrist now directly under that left shoulder. This time it's right foot in front of left, right arm reaching out to the right. Take a big inhale, and then exhale, come all the way up and over. You make that great big rainbow shape. And then inhale, you lower back down, look over to that right hand. Exhale, rainbow up and over, get that side stretch, push the ground away, stay strong on that left arm, and inhale, lower back down. Your body's between two panes of glass, so you wanna make sure you stack your hips, get everything nice and flat there. Lower back down. Okay, we got two more. Exhale, lift up, reach over, find the stretch. And then inhale, tap those hips down. Okay, last one. We're gonna be here a little bit longer. Lift up into that lateral flexion first. Then bring your hips down a little bit. Find your side plank. Okay, do not move your pelvis. Twist your chest as you thread the needle. Pull that right hip back in opposition. And then open it back up just for two. Twist. And open. Okay, last one. Twist. And open it up. And then bring it all the way down, heels to booty. Stretch it up and over. Okay, we're gonna come back into a plank just to transition out of class. So palms on the mat. Go ahead and find your plank here. Booty up in line with those shoulders. Pull that belly button away from the ground. And then from here, your gaze is down and slightly ahead. Keep everything nice and strong, nice and active. Heels together, toes apart. Let's do a little hinge. So you're gonna come up onto your tippy toes, the whole shape moves forward, and then reach your heels back, the whole shape moves back. So notice my booty is not going up and down, I'm going straight forward, straight back. Think about your head, the crown of your head is an arrowhead. Reach it forward, like you're gonna tap that wall in front of you for four. Keep those heels squeezed together, squeeze your bottom. Three, pull that belly button in, don't let it sink. For two, spread those fingers, push the ground away. Last one, find center, and then pike your hips up. Walk your hands all the way back to your feet. Let's hang in a forward fold for a second. Shake out your head. Shake your head no, nod your head yes. Shake out your neck was what I meant to say. And then from here, little bend in your knees, big breath in. As you exhale, restack your spine, bring your arms with you, reach out through the fingertips, come all the way up, bone by bone. Once you're up, the arms can come down by your sides, and then you're just gonna roll those shoulders. Oh, I can't see you. Roll those shoulders up, back, and down. Stand tall, pretend I'm standing all the way up, and you guys are done. Great job. Thanks for joining me. Oh, we went 25 minutes, so you got a little extra. Okay, bye.